Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show on Legends 100.3, the place to fine-tune your swing, dress for the course, club, or cruise, and get tips on the best places to play and stay at the right price. Vacation or staycation, host Dan Shube, along with his expert guests, will tell you where to go to play golf and vacation, that is. Now, here's Dan.
Welcome to the Golf and Travel Show. I'm your host, Dan Shube, and this morning we're going to be talking some golf. We're going to be talking some travel. I've got some travel news for you. I've also got a bunch of great travel deals later in the show. Of course, joining me from Legends Radio here in the studio this morning is Mike McGann. Welcome, Mike. Good to see you.
Always great to see you, my friend. And hey, it's going to be a great program. It's a lovely weekend.
It is. And in addition to that, in just a few moments, we'll be chatting with our guest, teen entrepreneur Layla Quick of OMG Lemonade. I had the pleasure of meeting her recently at the PGA Merchandise Show, and her lemonade is awesome. Great story. So looking forward.
I'm excited for that because that story is so cool, inspirational, fascinating on like every possible level. So I'm psyched to hear from her.
Yes, it's a perfect fit with golf, with travel, and having a good drink, which who doesn't do once in a while?
It's going to be a very refreshing discussion.
Absolutely. Well said. Speaking of refreshing, I'd like to welcome also our new sponsor, Retirement Network Advisors, Jupiter Joe Thomas. He's not just a friend, but he actually advises me on retirement issues, which are dear to my heart at this time in my life.
He's a great guy, a ton of experience, and just really, Joe is awesome to have with us.
He is. He's trustworthy. Like I say, I trust him myself, and you can do the same. You could reach him at jupiterjoe.com and tell him that I sent you. First, though, let's talk a little bit about the golf world. And last week, congratulations go out to Luke List, who won for the first time on the PGA Tour at the Farmers Classic in a playoff over Will Zalatoris. And unfortunately for Will, he's also trying to get his first win. He was the Rookie of the Year, but has come close, but not quite there. And unfortunately, this week, he will not win either. And I know that not because I'm psychic, but because he had to drop out because he tested positive for COVID. So that's how he is. He's coming in second isn't bad. You get a nice paycheck, and
sure,
certainly you had a great week if you managed to do that. But you know, the pros, of course, coming in second for them is a little bit of an empty feeling. So then he had to cap that off by having to withdraw and being sick. So he's probably not very happy. But my guess is that he's going to come back and be really angry. And just he's going to want that win desperately. So I wouldn't be surprised if in the coming weeks we hear more from Will Zalatoris.
Wow.
Also, right here down the road in Boca Raton last week, Lydia Ko held off Danielle Kang to win the Gainbridge LPGA event. And it was a little bit chilly, but she pulled it off. So congratulations to her. This week, finishing up a little bit later today, and of course you can tune in and watch that. We have from Pebble Beach, the PGA Tour will be playing the AT&T Pebble Beach Pro-Am. Watched some of it earlier, and of course all the celebrities are in the field, and a lot of fun to watch them all, including Bill Murray. Of course, he's always the funniest guy out there. But of course, a lot of musicians as well are playing, and it's just a lot of fun. And of course, the golf course itself is just incredibly beautiful. So you can't beat watching that.
No way.
Also, the LPGA is right here in Florida, over in Fort Myers, and this is a first-time event, and normally I would say that you can turn on the network and watch it, or better yet, drive over there to see it, but you can't.
Okay.
Because the public was not invited to this event. It's not open to the public, so you can't go there to watch, and it is not on the Golf Channel either. They've been showing parts of it on NBC Peacock, if you get that, and that's a pay channel.
Yes.
So you have to pay for that. And also, I believe that the LPGA itself is going to be doing some streaming. So you might be able to tune into LPGA.com. And it's a bit of an experiment, like everybody else in the world. They're trying to get more control over their lives and their employment situations and, you know, their revenue. And
sure.
The LPGA is no different. So rather than outsource this to someplace else, they thought, hey, what would it be like if we did this ourselves? And we'll see. I'm not overly optimistic. You know, I don't know. Their ratings aren't so huge either, and that's unfortunate because the women are a lot of fun to watch. And, of course, the women, their swings are more typical and common to the average amateur golfer. So rather than watching somebody like Bryson DeChambeau hit a 360-yard drive, watching the women on the LPGA, probably most of us amateur golfers can learn a little bit more from watching them. So hopefully in the coming weeks, we'll be able to tune in like we usually do on the networks or on the Golf Channel, and we'll see how this experiment goes. Speaking of experiments, in the coming weeks, we will have additional guests that I'm working on from the PGA Merchandise Show, just like this week, what we're going to do. So stay tuned. I think the best advice I can give you is make sure that you go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow.
Okay.
Like the page. And when you do that, you will be advised of who all of our guests are going to be, just like our guest this week, Layla Quick from OMG Lemonade. So I think what we are going to do now is take a quick break. We're going to get Layla on the line, and we're going to find out a little bit more about OMG Lemonade, how she came to be at the PGA Merchandise Show, and how this business is spreading like wildfire throughout the country, because it seems people are thirsty for a product that tastes as good as this one.
Nicely put.
So what we're going to do is take a quick break, and we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show. You won't want to miss it, so please stay tuned.
If you call double or nothing, to him that means double the green.
Hi, Golf and Travel listeners. It's Dan Shube here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shube, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say.
And we are back. And as everybody knows, about 2 weeks ago, I was up in Orlando for the PGA Merchandise Show, had an opportunity to meet with a lot of different companies that are there this year. A lot of the bigger companies didn't show up, giving an opportunity to some of the smaller companies to kind of shine and get a little bit more attention, which is something I like to do anyway. But I was fortunate to meet up with the folks from OMG Lemonade and sampled their product, and it tasted so wonderful that I thought I would share it with all of you. And of course, it's a wonderful story about how the company started and the team who began it all. And I could tell you all the story, but I thought it'd be a lot better to hear it right from the horse's mouth. And for that reason, we've got with us this morning 18-year-old Layla Quick from OMG Lemonade, and she's going to tell us all about it. Layla, are you there?
Hi, good morning. Good
morning.
Good afternoon. I am here.
Good morning. Now, it is still morning here, but in any event, it's a pleasure to have you here on the show with us. And I got an opportunity, like I say, the taste of the product is great, and the people who are listening are going to have to take our word for it until they can get a sample themselves. But the whole story of why you were there at the PGA Merchandise Show in the first place and how you came to start this business, I found to be fascinating, and I thought that the listeners would agree. So why don't we start with how you with the product itself and how you came to make your own lemonade and offer it to the public as well. How did it all begin?
Yes. It all started, thank you for that introduction. OMG Lemonade all started actually when I was 14 at the time. So how I got started, my mom had took this amazing trip to Dubai, right? But she didn't take me with her. And so she took her dream trip there. And she told me about when she walked into this glamorous hotel, she experienced this mint limeade, right? And she was like, I drank it every single day, and it was so good. And when she got back home to America, she was like, I'm either going to move to Dubai or I'm going to find a way to recreate it here. So my mom was like, we're going to have a competition between your older sister and I was 14, and my older sister was actually considered like the house chef. She could make like the best dishes, so everybody was convinced, okay, your sister's going to make the lemonade. And so we ended up figuring out there was over 600 varieties of mint, and we decided to do a mint lemonade instead. And it was like I was going through all these different types of mint, couldn't find that perfect flavor. And, you know, we figured out, whoa, I looked, one time I went in the back porch, it was the mint that I needed in a pot on my back porch.
Wow.
I love that.
Yeah, it was meant to be, obviously.
That's so cool.
Continue. Go ahead. Sorry to interrupt it.
No. And so after that, one of my mom's friends from Dubai came back to America, and they were like, this is it. They tried the lemonade, and they were like, yeah, this is it. And so basically everyone would come over just to drink the lemonade at my house, and my mom was like, Layla, this is so good. You should bottle it up. And so I did. I put it in my first bottle. I didn't know nothing about the beverage industry in the beginning because it was like it started off from just an idea, and we weren't even initially trying to create a business, but we decided to figure out how to bottle, figured out we went to a beer company, and they taught us how to preserve and sterilize bottles, and I put it in the first jar, took it to my very first event, which was a trade show that my mom was doing. She was an entrepreneur at the time, and that was how I got the inspiration to, like, you know, do my own thing. And I took it to my first event, had no label on it, first girl to open it up and take that first sip, said, oh my god, this is good. So that was probably
oh, I love it.
That's great.
Oh, yeah. And then it moved on till 2020, actually got started. How did we get into golf? We got started on a golf course. I was pitching OMG Lemonade on a hole, actually, with a whole banner set up, table, tent, and I would serve the golfers lemonade, and they would actually buy my lemonade and love it and drink it. And we were like, wait, golfers love our lemonade. This is a real thing. And so that's how we got started on the golf course. In 2020 is really when our brand took off. We did a lot of market research before. We sold out of 100 bottles within the first hour at the Black Farmers Market, and we started off with the Front Back Nine Golf, which is actually the brand where I got to learn how to pitch my business on a golf course. And so golf was like, yeah, that's it. Like, it was like, wow, it was like the missing piece. And so we sold out of 100 bottles within that first hour, and we scaled to 400 bottles, and then we also started with $20 in 2020, and we were able to scale to six figures in 1 year. So that was when we were like, okay, the business.
Okay, wait a minute. How old are you?
I'm 18.
Okay, I'm 49 years old.
She has a soul of like a 50-year-old, though.
It's mind-blowing, because I've got a pretty good career, but if I had been as focused, if I'd had your understanding of branding, marketing, and that sense of self-worth you seemed to have when I was your age, I would probably be president at this point. So this is mind-blowing. This is such a great, cool story. You are an incredible inspiration. Hearing those numbers is really, I don't normally talk a lot during these interviews, but this one's really, really blowing my mind.
It's very cool. And now tell us a little bit about how you came to be at the PGA Merchandise Show, which of course is the biggest golf event in the entire world once a year. It's very expensive to exhibit there. You don't typically see a lemonade company or a small business person as small as you starting out there. I mean, there are a few, and they don't usually show up the second year. But how is it that you came to be there?
Yes, and thank you. I'm very grateful to be as young as I am doing the things I'm doing, and that's because you know, I really focused on where I wanted to be, and I did a lot of self-discovery, and I learned at an early age that your gift is inside of you. And it took a little while for me to focus on that and really get my vision and understand my imagination is actually leading you to where you want to go in life. So once I realized your thoughts create your reality, that really was like the striking point in my journey. So PVA Merchandising Show, I'm so grateful to have had that opportunity. The way that I actually got the chance to be there was the African American Golf Expo. I had signed up with them and I sponsored their event. And through that event, I got the opportunity to actually go into a pitch competition. And that pitch competition was the Share Your Story competition. And it was about share the obstacles that you overcame in business. And it was share three obstacles. And we actually listed 20 obstacles that we overcame. Because, of course, it wasn't easy, you know, but with hard work and imagination and grit and hard and work ethic, anything is possible. So I pitched the PGA. My story, my brand story, is actually in the link in my bio. You can see the pitch video if you guys ever want to go and look at that. And they literally loved it. I was the first place winner of the Share Your Story competition. So super stoked, super excited. And yeah, that's how OMG Lemonade got its place at the PGA show. And when I tell you, I was so excited just about the reviews and the way they were so receptive of the company, I was just like, wow, like that really blew my mind. And I was so excited and happy to be there to just witness that. And so just really, yeah.
Well, you're the poster child for law of attraction working. I mean, you really are. This is so cool.
Yeah, there's about millions and millions and millions of people out there who are not working who need to be listening and find a way. If you don't want to work for somebody else, then go work for yourself.
Do it this way. Live that vision. Focus on the eyes on the prize, which is exactly what you've done. This is inspiring me like you have no idea.
Yeah. Now why don't you tell us briefly about your van that you have that I got to see, because that was pretty cool.
She's got a van.
New growth thing. Yeah, they got a beautiful wrapped van. So how did that come about?
Yes, the OMG Mobile. Quick manifestation tip. Never 2021.
Oh, you're the best.
That's what
I
call her, though. We wrote, I'm going to have a van in March 2020, in 2021. And literally, it manifested itself in that same month. And when I tell you, you don't even have, you just write what you want, and you're putting it into the universe, what you desire, and then you take those inspired actions and those steps to get where you want to go. You can't just write it and then no longer do nothing, but you have to work towards it, and it literally manifested. And so we designed it with our brand designer, and we were able to drive it in to the PGA Convention Center. So that was awesome. And I got there, and it was actually not even planned. I was like, I want to bring my van in. And it was like, I saw the other cars in there, and they were like, that's fine, come on, bring it in. And we literally parked it in the convention center, which is awesome. We put the lemonade in like a big glass, and we put the samples up for everybody to try. And it was just overall super awesome.
Well, yeah. Now that we're talking about the samples, so you had mentioned that mint was your first flavor. And it's excellent. Yes. I mean, I like to drink a lot of iced tea as well as lemonade. I'm not a carbonated beverage person, so I like to have iced tea with some mint in it. Not only does it taste good, but it also is good for your stomach. It settles it, which is nice. So it tastes wonderful. It's healthy. But what are the other flavors that you have available as well?
Yes, mint is, if y'all want to travel to Dubai, you travel to Dubai with a mint lemonade. We have the strawberry mint, and if you want to feel like you're in America, between America and Dubai, you know, we put the strawberry for the American flavor, and we mixed it with a mint. And if y'all know, we're the first to ever make that flavor, so that one is super good. We have also a strawberry passion fruit that's a fan favorite, and that one's like a Hawaii feel. And then we have a regular lemon drip lemonade, which is your original flavor. Also, juicy ginger lemonade, that's good for your immunity. And it gives it that, it's healthy, but it tastes good, not like a ginger shot. And we have lemon balm lemonade, which is also herbal, and it's the cousin of mint. And what it does is it helps relieve anxiety and relax you. So we mix it with like a lemonade, and it tastes real lemony. And we also have a pineapple paradise lemonade.
Oof.
You're making me salivate because I'm remembering the taste that I had when I saw you, and I want more. But I'm sure everybody is probably salivating, and I know that you know your products are available in many retail locations, but this is a big country, and not everybody can get to where you are. But you do sell your product online as well. So why don't you let everybody know your website so that they can purchase some and taste it like I had the opportunity to.
Yeah, so you guys can go on omglemonade.com and you can get all the flavors that I just listed on there, and we can ship it to you in an ice cold styrofoam cooler box, and it comes to you personalized and it comes ice cold. What better way than ice cold package at your front door, right?
Your reviews are just sitting at flat 5 stars.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, told it's five you, it tastes great. It's,
she's one of my, apologies to all my business owner friends and all the people that I hang out with.
Yeah, they can improve. They have a ways to go
like
to catch up.
She's like my favorite person.
Well, you're going to have to follow her as well on social media.
I'm on the website right now. I mean, we're
like
going
I am.
There.
So, so it says omglemonade.com. You can buy it by the bottle. You could buy it in larger bottles as well. I think they're half gallons, I believe you have, for the real thirsty folks out there, right?
Yes, exactly.
So place an order, get your OMG lemonade. Not only does it taste good, obviously it's healthy, and it's a great story. It's nice to support young minority women-owned businesses, family businesses, and it's my pleasure to have you on the show and share the story with all the listeners. Hopefully some of them will place some orders and be enlightened like I am, and hopefully I'll see you and your family again at the PGA Merchandise Show again next year.
Yeah, thanks for inviting us, Dan. It's really been great. Yeah.
Well, it's my pleasure. Oh. Say hello to the rest of your family as well. Keep doing what you're doing, and we'll be watching you, okay?
I just friend requested you, by the way.
Right. Good, Mike. all the rest of your business associates can really be jealous now.
Right, so cool. I love this.
All right, Layla, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it. All righty. What we're going to do is we're going to take a quick break. We've got some travel news and some deals on travel. You won't want to miss it, so stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show.
A lot of men didn't. A lot of men died. I hook it to the left. I shank it to the right. I'll be looking for my ball until the dark of the night. You play 18 holes. What?
Hi, golf and travel listeners. It's Dan Shoub here with a message for your retirement. Golf and retirement go hand in hand. And when looking for a retirement advisor, trust and experience are two qualities to look for. And my friend, Jupiter Joe Thomas, possesses both of these. Whether you're in retirement or looking to retire, give local expert Joe Thomas a call at 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Mention my name, Dan Shoub, and receive a free copy of Joe's book, Retirement Know-It-All. After I read his book, I became a client. His advice has allowed me to sleep easy and not worry about retirement. Phone again is 561-743-0999. That's 561-743-0999. Or just go to JupiterJoe.com. That's JupiterJoe.com. Easy, right?
Are back, and we only have a few minutes left, so I'm going to talk fast like I normally do. I apologize. You can always reach out to me through facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. Send me a message, and I can repeat or help you with any information you need. On the news side, last week, it seems that a SpaceX launch was scrubbed because a Royal Caribbean ship was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
What?
So the Coast Guard is investigating why Royal Caribbean had to cause this to be scrubbed. And God only knows what the expense is of having to scrub a launch.
What, were they like going to have the booster rocket crash into the ship?
Yeah, something
like
that.
That's the only thing I can figure.
Yeah,
right?
Or if they have to abort for some reason, I guess they need like a landing area.
Place to dump
or something.
Out.
Yeah, so that's interesting. There's lots of other stories, of course, about people being thrown off of planes. I'm not going to bore you with all of them, but there have been plenty. Many of them are flights that started here in Florida. So we've got some wonderful people here in Florida that refuse to follow the rules and end up getting tossed from flights and, you know, making everybody else late, which nobody's happy about.
Right.
How about some good airline news, though? Delta is doing an experiment right now in the Boston area to see what happens if they offer more people a checked bag for free as opposed to carrying their bag on.
Okay.
Because obviously, you know, there's only limited room in the overheads and it causes issues. And, you know, let's face it, the airlines make a lot of money charging people to check bags. So Delta might sacrifice some profit to do that, to make their customers happy.
Right.
And very unusual in any business, especially the airline business. So let's hope that they do that. And of course, in the long run, they're hoping that they'll get more happy customers and make money in the long run. But typically they look at the short run and try and, you know, nickel and dime everybody as much as they can. So hopefully that's good. Also, the airlines are very, very short on staff, which has caused lots of flights to be canceled. Pilots, as well as other kinds of engineers and people that do maintenance, and they are upping the salaries and offering large bonuses, tens of thousands of dollars of bonuses and stuff to get people. The problem is to train new pilots takes years.
I was going to say, it's not a quick turnaround.
Right. So either they have to convince people that have decided to retire or go into a different line of work to come back, or they got to wait. So it's an issue. So we'll see. But nobody likes the fact that flights are being canceled and, you know, there's less options. So we'll have to see. How about some deals? I know you love this part of the show, Mike.
I do.
My daughter and son-in-law were just out in the wine country and had a wonderful time. It's typically very expensive, but on TravelZoo.com, I found a DoubleTree in Rohnert Park, which is the Sonoma area, for as little as $139 a weeknight night in February. It goes up to about $169 if you want to push it back into the spring, and weekends are also a couple of dollars more, but that's still very cheap for nice hotel in the wine country. Also, found a great deal, 10-night guided tour through Exotica. It's a reputable firm. This includes guided tours, airfare, pretty much everything for 10 nights to Ecuador. So, of course, you're going to get to see, you know, the giant tortoises and, you know, just incredible nature, you know, from that part of the area, you know, the world. So if you're into nature, you get a boat trip along Santa Cruz Bay, and you get to see active volcanoes. You get to see mineral hot springs. All of that is little as $16.99 for 10 nights.
$16.99.
Includes all your breakfast, round trip airfare from here in flights within Ecuador as well, a boat trip, guides, entry fees, incredible deal. How about some airfare deals? Just go to Google Flights and put in where you're going to. Every place pretty much in the Caribbean is on sale from Fort Lauderdale right now. San Jose, Costa Rica on sale, all of these under $200. And Europe is on sale between $400 and $500, all of Europe.
That still kills me because I'm used to that being a grand.
Unbelievable. So thanks to our guest, of course, OMG Lemonade and Layla Quick. Go to omglemonade.com for more information. And of course, our new sponsor, Retirement Network Advisors, jupiterjoe.com. Go there, tell him we sent you. You could get his free book. And I use him and I recommend that you do too. And of course, facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. Like the page, you'll know who our guests are going to be. And you could always message me there with any questions. Be happy to help you. And of course, tune in again next week for another episode of the Golf and Travel Show.
Every day is an endless stream of cigarettes and magazines.
Thanks for listening to the Golf and Travel Show hosted by Dan Shoup. Dan's here every Sunday at 7 a.m. to help you hit him straight, whether you're in Palm Beach County or traveling around the world. We'll see you next Sunday morning for more of the Golf and Travel Show right here on Legends 100.3.